about that? Send us some with the car if you need to ride somewhere. Well, it's not safe to be hanging out down here by yourself, you know. A lot of pigs patrol us there. That's cute. What happened to his hat?
It kept falling off, so I sewed it into his leg.
Can you place the crash? I mean, I live close by and people stay all the time.
Boy, Michael. What's up?
Routine. A mystery of emotion that begins in puberty, flourishes briefly, then fades away furtively under the onslaught of time. Routine.
There's still some beer.
Relatively silenced like an explosive. 18 million of them in the United States alone. And the number increasing every day. 18 million
have a seat. I'm going to go find Rob.
18 million young people looking for an identity. Looking for a place in this world. And bringing with them a new vitality. A new sensuality. A new morality. Not satisfied with the world they have been born into. Teenagers are no longer content to sit by and wait for things to happen. Grouped together, unafraid, into clubs, political parties, and even mobs, they are making themselves heard. From London to Tokyo, from Berkeley to Rome, the teenager carries his banners in defiance. Ban the bomb. Make love, not war. Freedom for four-letter words. Fighting for big changes or little changes, the teenager is revolting against society.
You sure?
You don't smoke.
Okay. It'll probably help you fall asleep.
Their own temple, their own set of rituals to go with it. Across the country on every Friday and Saturday night, they gather in the temples to perform. Ceremonies to reach back in time beyond history. It's called the beast.
haven't been feeling very well.
You'll be okay. Just close your eyes. You'll be okay. Is that thing still hurting?
Yeah. I think so.
There's a party tonight at Ray's. You want to go?
No. That's okay.
Well, if you want, you can sleep here. I won't be home until morning.
I'll just crash on the couch when I get back. Careful you don't get too much smoke.
You'll get the hang of it.
I know this must be strange to you, you know, being around people that you hardly know. It's strange how life works out, isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, like, when I saw you yesterday, I felt there was a reason for me to be there. I felt like I needed to help you. Had these for about 10 years. I was a pretty morbid teenager. I liked pain. Sometimes I still do. It's like if you can center the pain in one area, you can change the emotional pain to the physical pain. Sometimes it's easier to deal with. I don't want to talk about that now. I know that's not the good way. What was I saying? It's just so amazing how whenever you really need something in life, it comes. And never when you're expecting it. Like my sister Meredith, she helped me through that time.
I wish I'd had someone like that.
I'm so lucky she's a part of my life. You'll get to meet her tomorrow, and you'll meet Amber too. I don't really know how to feel about Amber. I just wish I knew how she felt about me. Sometimes I miss her so much, I feel like I'm going crazy. So afraid of being alone.
It doesn't seem like you have to worry about that. You have so many friends.
My friends are my family. Rob and Mike are like my brothers. And you'll be part of our family too. As long as you have us, we'll make sure you're never hurt. I promise. If you ever want to talk, I'm here. Cricket? Cricket? What's your name?
It's Jennifer. What are you doing? I missed you today. What have you been doing?
I'm Meredith. How are you?
Fine, thanks. I like your place.
Thanks. It's pretty much a shithole, but then again, I'm the only person who bothers to clean around here, and I'm not very good at that.
Are you hungry? We brought some food.
Name, where'd you get it?
Oh, my mom used to call me that when I was little.
Really? That's cool. Are you close?
We used to be.
Your lazy ass out of bed. It's almost one.
So bloody hungry. I'm a terrible hoarder. I never throw anything away. Like this. I've had this since the 8th grade. I don't wear it anymore. Do you want it? Thanks. Anything wrong? No one's ever just given me things. You don't even know me. Doing things for other people makes me feel good. I wished everyone was like that. So do I. It seems like Ian is. Yeah. Ian's really great. He's always been there for me. He tries to be cool, but I'm one of the few people who knows how really caring he is. We've always been able to talk about things. I used to be able to talk to Rod like that, but lately something's changed. I hope you don't mind. It's the only way I can deal with Rob anymore. I'll do your hair.
12 o'clock, I was no many pages on
page
80. Well, talk to Rob, and we decided to give you a hit of bats if you want to try. And go ahead, here for the work. Lots of fun. It won't take you to another world, but it'll give you a different way of looking at this world. Where everything is beautiful, that means you can be lucky.
I can't believe you showed all the doses without saving any for me and Meredith. You think you could score on that?
Who's that girl? Oh, that's Heather. She's just one of Bob's girlfriends.
So, what does that make you?
You know, I ask myself that same question every day. God, I haven't even been home for 24 hours. You know, he told me he wasn't going to do the X anymore. I don't expect that much from him. I really don't. I just can't stand and want to. I know he loves me, but he just always puts drugs first.
You know, Cricket, drugs can be fun, but don't let them redeem you, okay? Are you going to do the X tonight?
I don't know. One of these days we should just sit down and talk. I'd really like that. Me too.
Thanks for letting me back. I'm with my mom. You have fun. If you feel like everything that is going, just come in, okay?
Thank you.
she's in.
This is the first fucking shit. I swear to God, it's gonna be the only thing I've ever known.
Is that okay? Thanks, Heather. Come to me, my beautiful love, and lay here by my side. To be with you, if only once, would truly be a joy. Permit me to show you all that I know, to hold you close and kiss your lips, to touch your soul with mine. Brown me in the light that is you, my love, and let me keep you till the dawn.
Beautiful. Really beautiful.
Thanks. There's something I'd really like to read to you. I'm gonna go get it. Okay?
That's your fucking problem.
Great, what am I supposed to do now?
That's not my problem.
Fuck you.
Oh my god. I thought you were mine.
Why? What would you want with him? He never has anything to say. Nothing important anyway.
Oh. But his poetry is beautiful.
Oh god. You're into poetry too, huh? As bad as Meredith. I bet you believe in true love too, huh? It's just not possible, so don't even look for it.
Talking about.
So how come you never talk, huh? What are you hiding? Some deep dark secret from me?
I just haven't felt like talking.
Yeah? Well, you don't need to talk. Because I already know what you're thinking. I know what you were thinking when I saw you this morning. You can't live your life denying yourself what you want.
I don't know what I want.
Well, I just want you to know. Everything I do, I have a reason for. And if you don't understand it now, you will in the future. You like that? Huh? Hey. I asked you if you liked it. Hmm? Do you?
I don't know.
This world anymore.
Don't say things like that. Cricket, what happened to you? Doesn't matter. Nothing matters. Don't talk like that. Tell me what it is. I
I want to help you. I can't tell you.
Rob and Mary have another fight?
He's been so hard on her lately. He didn't used to be like this. He just doesn't know how to deal with things. I mean, he wants what he wants, but... he just doesn't know how to deal with people. He'd rather escape. Tell me what's wrong.
I don't know.
What do you mean?
Remember anything. Sometimes I hear voices, and they tell me that I'm bad. And then it's all my fault.
You're not bad, Cricket.
Yes, I am.
Cricket, I need to tell you something. I came back to the living room last night. I saw you with Rob. I'm sorry, I was pretty fucked up, and we were having so much fun, I saw you with him, and I thought you wanted to be with him. Not me.
I thought he was you for a minute. I don't remember you leaving, but I was having fun until you did.
Really?
Really.
Okay. Why don't you get some sleep? Then tomorrow we can do something together. if you want. It'll be really special. I promise.
Thanks, Michael. Are you okay? Rob didn't come home last night. Meredith? There's something I need to tell you. Good, I need to know. What did he do to you? Did he hurt you? Did he rape you? I like it here.
I thought you would. Isn't this near where you met Ian?
Yeah, I think so.
Actually, this is where Rob and Meredith met. She and Ian came down and Rob and I were really stoned.
So, what do you want to do today?
Well, actually, I brought something here for us.
What is it?
This will make you feel like a little kid again.
Really? How?
Why don't you take it and find out? Don't worry. I've tripped enough times to know how to handle it. So I won't let anything bad happen, okay? Let's play.
bitch. It's all your fault.
What does it mean?
Come on.
What does it mean?
Michael? Honey, you've had some night. Did you have any idea you were pregnant?
No.
11 weeks. That's almost the second trimester. Here's your bag. Your friends thought you might need it. They weren't able to give us adequate information about you. What's your full name?
Cricket.
I need your real name. We need to contact your family.
I don't have a family.
They must be worried sick about you. No wonder you miscarried. Hanging around with all those people and all those drugs pumping through your body. Maybe you'll be more cooperative with the daylight staff. Get some rest.
Time.